He fed them with the finest sweet, and satisfied them with honey from the rock. In the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Let's be aware of the grace of Christ God. You were sent to heal the contrite of heart, Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners, Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You intercede for us at the right hand of the Father, Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Heavenly God, have mercy on us, and give us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. O God, strength of those who hope in you, graciously hear our pleas. Since without your mortal frailty you do nothing, grant us always the help of your grace. And in following your commands, we may please you by our resolve and our deeds. Our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. A reading from the second book of Kings. The Lord was about to take Elijah to heaven in a whirlwind. He and Elisha were on their way from Gilgal. Elijah said to Elisha, "Please stay here. The Lord has sent me on to the Jordan. If the Lord lives and as you yourself live, I will not leave you," Elisha replied. So the two went on together. If they have the Gilgal prophets followed, and when the two stopped at the Jordan, they stood facing them. Elijah took his mantle and rolled it up and struck the water which divided, and both crossed over on dry ground. When that crossover, Elijah said to Elisha, "Ask for whatever I may do for you before I get taken from you." Elisha answered, "May I receive a double portion of your spirit?" "You have asked something that is not easy," Elijah replied. "Still, if you see me taken up from you, your wish will be granted. Otherwise not." As they walked along, the mercy of the flaming chariot and flaming horses came between them, and Elijah went up to heaven in the whirlwind. When Elisha saw it happen, he cried out, my father, Israel's chariots and drivers." When he could no longer see him, Elisha gripped his own garment and tore it in two. Then he picked up Elijah's mantle that had fallen from him, back and stood at the bank of the Jordan. Wielding the mantle that had fallen from Elijah, Elisha struck the water in his stern and said, "Where is the Lord, the God of Elijah?" And Elisha struck the water and divided it, and he crossed over. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Let your hearts take comfort, all who hope in the Lord.
Let your hearts take comfort.
How great is the goodness, O Lord, which you have in store for those who fear you, and which for those who take refuge in you, you show in the sight of the children of men.
Let
your hearts take comfort, all who hope in the Lord. You hide them in the shelter of your presence from the plottings of men. You screen them within your abode from the strife of tongues.
Let your hearts take comfort, all who hope in the Lord.
Love the Lord, his faithful ones. The Lord keeps those who are constant, but more than requites those who are act proudly.
Let your hearts take comfort, all who hope in the Lord.
The Lord be with you. We bring
you
the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said to his disciples, "Take care not to perform righteous deeds, in order that people may see them. Otherwise, you will have no recompense from your Heavenly Father. When you give alms, not blow a trumpet before you as the hypocrites do in the synagogues and in the streets to win the praise of others. And then I say to you, they have received their reward. But when you give alms, do not let your left hand know what your right hand is doing, so that your alms may be secret. And your Father who sees in secret will repay you. When you pray, do not see them. And then I say to you, they have received the reward. When you pray, you'll be that they appear to others to be fasting. Then I say to you, they have received a reward. When you fast, anoint your head, wash your face, so that you may not appear to others to be fasting, except to your Father who is hidden. Your Father who sees what is hidden will repay you. The Gospel of the Lord. So did Elijah and Elisha put on a show, or was it genuine? There's 50 guild members standing right there. He takes off his nail, puts it in the water, and then walks across. Or maybe what they're probably doing is the guild members are so close, so they need to practice it, that we're going to get over to the other side, because otherwise all the gossip's going to be all over the place, because we know how gossip likes to go all over the place, so people hear things they shouldn't hear. And so who knows what it is? Both of the scriptures in some way talk about authenticity. What do you want, Elisha? I want two portions of your spirit. He asks for something that's hard to get. He asks for such a noble reality. Elijah is a great prophet, one who's leading people and actually finding lots of turmoil in his life. And Elisha is asking for the same thing, but to have double the portion of understanding the spiritual life in such a way to give myself as you gave, Elijah. I want to do even more than what you've done. It's giving himself, and it's genuine. Ultimately, the gospel is about being genuine. If you're going to pray because it's the genuineness of your heart to God, and allow God's Spirit to act. It's not about showing, it's not about praying, you're praying about anything else except that of God. If you're fasting, you're not doing it for any other purpose except, God, I know this is good for me, and I do it because you asked me to do it. We have a genuine relationship, and I do it for you. And yes, I'm doing it for myself as well, because I know it's good for me. Somehow, how do we get into this authenticity of life, or this relationship with God, and it transforms our being? Just something to think about this day. As you're going through your day, why are you doing the different tasks? What are the different thoughts you have? And is it really a genuine relationship with Christ? So that I myself become better. The world becomes better. My relationship with Christ becomes better. Just something to think about this week. Where is the authenticity this day where I truly give myself over because it's good for myself, the world, my relationship with God? Something to think about. We bring our needs to God. For the church, we receive the Holy Spirit's gift and prophecy as we strive to share the good news. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who hold public office, may God grant them perseverance in working for the common good. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who are in need of God's healing in mind or body, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our faith communities, may the Lord continue to transform us into His mercy and grace. We pray to the Lord. For the sick, that they may receive the grace and gifts of God, that they may share in the eternal peace of Christ, we pray to the Lord.
Lord,
we bring our needs to God. For the disease and for all I have nursed, we pray to the Lord.
Lord,
loving Father, hear these prayers we offer on behalf of your children and answer them in Christ our Lord. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, who carry this earth as prayer we offer to you, through the earth, the work of human hands, who will become for us bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, who carry this earth as wine we offer to you, through the vine and work of human hands, who become for us as prayer of life. Grant the prayer that the sustenance they provide. Spirit of God, we just do our salvation, always and everywhere, and give you thanks, O Holy Father, Almighty and Holy God. For just as your beloved Son you created in your grace, so also through him with great goodness you formed anew. So it is right that all your creatures serve you, all redeemed, praise you, all the saints with one heart bless you. We too extol you with all the angels as a joyful celebration we claim. Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed be the King who comes in the name of the Lord.
Hosanna in the highest.
You are made holy, O Lord, the Father of all holiness. Holy, therefore, these gifts we pray, sitting down your servant upon them like the dewfall. So that we come for us, body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time there was a tribute in your will and name was fashioned, he took bread and gave thanks for it. He gave to his disciples, saying, take this all of you and eat it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when someone was in the chalice, once more he gave thanks to his disciples, saying, take this all of you and drink it. But this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new eternal covenant, which we pour out for you for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. Now, mystery of faith, when we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you the bread of life and chalice of salvation, giving thanks to your fellows worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Hallelujah, we pray that taking the body of our Christ and gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. We would like your church, which throughout the world, bring into the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Gerald, our bishop, and all the clergy. Remember our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, all who died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, and the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Blessed Joseph, her spouse, and the blessed apostles, and all the saints and patients throughout the ages. And may merit to be co-heirs to the life of the praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, O glory and honor is yours forever. The sacred commandment from my divine teaching dare to say, Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, pray for our evil. Graciously grant peace in our days. That by the help of your mercy, we may always be considered safe from all distress. As we were blessed hope in the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, send your apostles, peace unto you, might be saved to you. Acknowledge our sins, love, and faith in your church. And graciously grant our peace in each accordance with your will, and that we reign forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always. We offer peace to your family members and these others. Lamb of God, take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold, Lamb of God, behold, who takes away the sins of the world. Bless those called and suffer of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter.
Let us pray. As this reception of your Holy Communion, Lord, foreshadows the union of the faithful to you, so may it bring about unity in your church through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you.